Sindle, the survivor. Hi everybody, my name is Bri, and this video is going to be a little bit different than what I normally have on my channel. We have officially added a new member to our family. He's extremely special on so many different levels. It's crazy. On Monday night, there was a fire that destroyed this woman's house. It burned everything. There's nothing left. She did get out and she's doing okay. She was hospitalized for a little bit. In the house fire, there were many deaths of quite a few animals. 3 cats, a whole litter of puppies, mom and the dad, and a couple other dogs. All of them were killed. Sadly, it's pretty rough. Though one puppy did manage to survive, and I don't know why, I don't know how. All I know is that he did, and he's mine. We were approached by the woman's granddaughter, who happens to be a very good friend of mine, and she asked me and Brayden if we wanted to take on this puppy, and how could I say no? I mean, I didn't even know anything about this puppy until I had already said yes to him. It was, hey, will you please take this puppy that's now been orphaned? Like, of course I will. And then we started learning his story, and it's really intense. I am so happy to have him, for us to have him. It's a miracle. When he was brought into the emergency vets, he was 10 days old. His eyes aren't open, and he suffered from smoke inhalation, second and third degree burns on his legs, his paws, and his ears. And of course, his fur was singed in some places. But other than that, he was okay. And the vets told us that he had a more than 50% chance of pulling through. And that got me thinking, I have to take the chance. If it's more than 50, that's basically 100, right? So Tuesday, we go in to the vet to see him. We were there for so long. We were there for, it felt like forever. Really, in reality, it was maybe 2 hours. We first thought that his vet bills would be $500. That's what we were told. It was gonna be $500 plus maybe a little more for extra medications. We don't know. When we got there, they were telling us that it was way more than 500. It was gonna be in the thousands. This puppy, through all odds, has survived this fire when none of the others could. But now, do we spend all of this money? Because medication doesn't always work. The vet was telling us the lowest we would have to pay was around $1,300. And the highest it would get would be around $2,000. So, as Brayden thought, we'll go for the bare minimum, we'll see if he pulls through kind of deal. I wasn't even thinking about costs. I was thinking of, well, what am I going to do when he's all better? I'm going to take him on walks. I'm going to teach him how to sit, how to stay, how to roll over, you know, the works. That's what I was thinking about. I wasn't thinking about money. Money's money. I didn't care how much it costed. I was going to save this puppy's life. I was already planning on 5 years down the road with him. And I haven't even seen him at this point. No idea what he looked like. We had an idea of what we wanted to name him. I wanted to see him before I could decide, because his name tells his story. So then the vet leaves us in the room, and me and Brayden are sitting with our friend and her mom, and we're kind of talking about, how are we going to pay for this? Do we want to pay for it? Should we just let him go? Should we find somebody else to adopt him who can financially support him. What are we going to do? So then he tells us that we need a $1,000 down payment that day. That kind of was a big stop sign, because being 17 and 18, we don't have that kind of money. You know, we minimum wage jobs don't pay for that kind of thing. So we kind of got a little, I kind of got a little scared, because money is money, but it doesn't grow on trees. We kind of just sat in silence for a little bit, because it was like, what are we going to do? How are we going to save him? They come back and they say, hey, we want to see this puppy live. We know he can do it. So our foundation has decided to donate $500 for you guys to help you out with costs, because we know that this is a big deal. It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. It's his life or his death, and we want to see him live. That was a weight lifted off my shoulders. It was the green light. This was, yes, we are going to save his life. And I didn't care how much it costed. We were gonna save his life. You know, we did. We were able to get the other $500 that day and put a down payment. And then I started a fundraiser online for him. I will put it right here in case you wanna go and look at it. We are still accepting donations. We still have the bills to pay. Anything helps. We did go with the kind of bare minimum of care with a little extra. It wasn't the exact bare minimum, it was a little extra. More health problems arose. When we did see him, he was in a little box of oxygen. Because of the smoke inhalation, he couldn't breathe on his own very well. So the oxygen helped him. And he was hooked up to feeding tubes because he wasn't able to do it on his own. The moment I turned around the corner and I saw him in that little box, I instantly connected with him. It was something I've never felt before. It was just me and him. And I know Brayden felt the same way. This was our puppy. He was gonna be ours. Seeing his little body curled up on a little towel with his little breath puffing on the glass, it was just beautiful. And I knew Sindle, the survivor. It was either gonna be Sindle or we were bumping between Ember, which means remains from a fire. Even though he is remains from a fire, it didn't fit him, because he's not only remains from a fire, he's a survivor, he's a fighter, he wanted to live. You could see it in the way his ears twitched. He wanted to live, and that's why he did. He pulled through. We would call every day asking for updates on how he's doing, what's going on, when we can bring him home. By Wednesday, he was doing so much better. He was getting the life brought back to him. By Thursday, he was off of feeding tubes completely and was suckling out of a bottle. That meant so much when I heard that, because I know that that's such a big step. And when we were told that he would be weaned off the oxygen soon, we knew that that was good too. That was his last big step. So then Thursday night, they took him off of the oxygen. The only thing we are worried about right now is his leg. He's got a big burn on the side of one of his back legs. His ears are burned, and he's got some burns on all of his paw pads are burned, and he's got minor burns on the tops of his paws. He might have to have his leg amputated. I don't necessarily want his leg gone. I wasn't very sad or upset that he might lose his leg. He's been through so much already, only being now 12 days old. One less leg is not gonna stop him. It's gonna make him even better. We are very close to paying off bills that we have right now, but if his leg doesn't start healing properly like it's supposed to be doing, we will have to amputate it. That's another, who knows how much added on, but I know that we can do it. We need help, of course. Doesn't anybody need help? He's worth it. And I will do everything I can to make sure that he continues to live. I really love him. Right now, I will insert the footage of his coming home and when we went and got him and how that all went down. There you go. Okay, so we are on our way to go get Sindle right now. He is off of his oxygen box that he's been in since Monday, and he was off of his feeding tubes the other day. So they said that he's ready to come home. The only thing we have to worry about now is the third-degree burns on one of his back legs. They aren't healing properly at the second, so we're just kind of playing it by ear, seeing how they heal in the next couple weeks or days, and seeing if we need to maybe do an amputation of part of his leg, which isn't that big of a deal, but I mean, it's his leg. But being only 12 days old, I don't think he's gonna miss it too bad if we do end up needing to amputate it. So yeah, we're gonna go see him. Hopefully he remembers me. We also have an interview with the news station on Sunday morning, and they're gonna go over his story and hopefully bring some public attention to him and help us with our fundraiser. It's really awesome how they reached out to us in order to help us. They somehow heard about it through the veterinary clinic and figured they'd do a story on us. So we're really thankful for that. So far in our fundraiser for him, we have raised $100, and that's aside from the $500 the veterinary clinic already donated for us to begin with. And that's what started this whole, like, we can save him kind of ordeal. It kind of gave us hope that no matter how hard it's gonna be, we're still gonna get him. And yeah, so hopefully with the news station helping us out, they will traffic more people to want to donate to us and help us save his life. And pretty hopeful. On our way to go get him, we stopped by the store and I kind of wanted to spoil him a little, so we got him a baby blanket and a new stuffed animal that he can cuddle with since he is orphaned. I didn't want him to feel alone in his box crate that he has to stay in until he's older, so I figured a little stuffed animal that he can cuddle with was pretty good. So we got him a little fox, and we also got him a heating pad because he needs help keeping his body temperature until he's about 5 weeks old. And yeah, we got a couple bottles and some formula, and we're pretty prepared. I can't believe this is actually happening.
And the blood will dry underneath my nails, and the wind will rise up to fill my sails.
Can you hear him squeaking?
Yes. He's looking for something to eat.
Here, show his leg. And his foot. Yeah, it's okay.
Oh, I think he's ready to go. Here's go.
Go. Hold on, wait, I want to push him back further. It's okay, boy. Right, there we go.
Coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away.
I'm coming home, tell the world I'm coming. got home with Sindle and couldn't be happier. Oh my kingdom.